Last-minute Christmas shoppers desperate for this year's must-have toys are being warned to look out for telltale signs of fake and potentially dangerous products as rogue online traders cash in on a surge in demand for sold-out items. Councils are also urging consumers to be wary of turning to suspect online sellers offering next-day delivery to secure toys that are out of stock elsewhere because they could be left out of pocket if the toys do not exist. In the final countdown to Christmas, councils have seized thousands of counterfeit and dangerous toys, including many that contained parts that pose a choking hazard to children. Thurrock Council seized 86% of all products tested, a total of 88,000 items, many of which were toys, which arrived at ports between July and September. The local government association, LGA, which represents 370 councils in England and Wales, said criminals were exploiting a spike in demand for must-have toys, with some appearing online at more than 6 times their recommended retail price. It warned parents desperate to buy the most popular toys, such as Fingerlings and Hatchimals, to avoid buying them at suspiciously low prices or from suspect websites as these may be run by fraudsters. The LGA urged shoppers to look for the CE mark on toys or packaging, which confirms they meet EU consumer safety standards. With people increasingly buying presents online, the LGA called for the CE mark to be clearly included in the information on websites that offered toys for sale. Christmas can be a great time for bargains, but it can also be a magnet for dodgy traders and criminals who won't think twice about making easy money from selling dangerous toys to unsuspecting shoppers, said Simon Blackburn, who chairs LGA Safer and Stronger Communities Board. Faulty electrical toys can lead to fires or electrocution, inferior materials can break and cause injuries, while toxic levels of ingredients can cause burns, illness and even prove fatal. Shoppers are also being urged to look out for grammar and spelling errors on packaging, telltale signs of counterfeit goods, and to be wary of cheap offers involving toys sold out elsewhere. Selling illegal fake toys is a crime and ruins the reputation of genuine traders, harms legitimate businesses, costs the economy millions in lost tax revenue and often funds organized criminal gangs, said Blackburn. The British Toy and Hobby Association, representing legitimate traders, said criminals were making an estimated £400 million a year from counterfeit toys. It called for a new agreement with China to jointly identify and stop these dangerous products.